respected President Sri Pranab Mukherjee and academic fraternity comprising academic administrators, faculty, students and staff located in length and breadth of our motherland watching this program. Sir, I dream it an honor and privilege to welcome you to this unique event when our beloved President will be delivering the New Year greetings and message to the academic community through National Knowledge Network. The Honorable President Sri Pranab Mukherjee is our father figure, who is not only the first citizen of our country, but the visitor to vast network of central universities, central institutions such as IITs, NITs, IISc, IIITs, ISERS, etc. Sir, we all look forward to you for inspiration, guidance and support to bring up our national institutions to global standards. President Sir, on behalf of faculty, students and staff of the higher education system of our country and particularly the institutions participating in this unique program through National Video Conferencing Network, I cordially welcome you, Sir, from the bottom of my heart on this special occasion, and we are all eagerly looking forward to your valuable message and guidance. I also extend a warm welcome to all Vice Chancellors, Directors, faculty, students and staff seated in the studios of respective institutions across the country, reflecting a true national and academic integration for a common goal. I welcome all officers, administrators, technical staff of Rashtrapati Bhavan, NIC, MHRD, government agencies, universities and institutions who made this exciting experiment possible. I also welcome all those watching this web-based program through internet. NKN and NMICT are wonderful national facilities with a great potential to synergize academic strength of the country by knowledge sharing for knowledge growth. Our Honorable President is a great motivator for this experiment. We are extremely grateful to you, Sir, for your tremendous push to uplift our higher education system. The whole academic community is deeply touched by your efforts. Your innovative ideas to have innovation club in universities and identify inspired teachers have rejuvenated the academic community. Your efforts to have regular VC conferences of central universities and institutions in Rashtrapati Bhavan have helped to brainstorm on crucial issues of higher education to improve the system. Your steps to take VCs with you for international visits will go a long way towards the internationalization of higher education. While your concern for standard of our education system is genuine, we promise you, Sir, that with your support and guidance, we shall strive to excel and elevate our institutions to global rankings. Now, I am extremely delighted, Sir, to invite you to kindly deliver the New Year message to the academic fraternity. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Good morning, Vice Chancellors of Universities, Directors of Indian Institute of Technology and National Institute of Technology, heads of other academic institutions, faculty members, my dear students. Let me begin by wishing you all and your families a very happy and prosperous New Year 2014. It is with great pleasure that I speak to you in the New Year. Throughout 2013, I have been closely interacting with various academic institutions. In February 2013, a conference of Vice Chancellors of Central Universities, and in November, a conference of directors of National Institute of Technology were held in Rashtrapati Bhavan. So far, I have visited and addressed over 45 institutions, including universities, IITs, and NITs. Thanks to the National Knowledge Network, it is now possible for me to reach out to all of you today to share some thoughts on higher education in India. I am grateful to Professor S.B. Raghavan and his team and NIC team for facilitating the video talk with you. Friends, as I have said earlier, education is the true alchemy that can bring India to its next golden age. My first and foremost concern is the quality of education in our country. The standard of higher education has a direct relationship with the development of a nation and the quality of life of its citizens. Two recent surveys conducted by reputed international organizations have brought out to the difference in the standards of education between institutions in India and abroad. None of the Indian universities find any place in the top 200 institutions. This was not the case in the past. Between the 6th century BC and the 12th century AD, our seats of higher learning, Nalanda, Takshashila, Vikramshila, Valavi, Shompura, and Udanpuri dominated the world. They were visited by knowledge seekers from around the world. But now, many bright Indian students go abroad for higher studies. Nobel laureate Hargobind Khurana, Subramaniam Chandrasekhar, Amartya Sen, and Venkatraman Ramakrishnan did their graduate or postgraduate studies in Indian universities before they went abroad to pursue higher learnings. Why is it that our higher education system that is capable of producing world-class scholars loses them to foreign institutions? Is it due to the lack of research facilities and opportunities for creative and innovative thinking? To nurture and retain talent, our institutions must increase their potential for research and promote an ecosystem conducive to creative and innovation. What we need today are mere collaborative partnerships on cutting-edge technology, better linkage with industry, and greater incentivization through scholarships. This will not only encourage meritorious students to do research, but also attract talent from foreign universities. In a country of over 1.2 billion people, only 8 Indians have so far won the Nobel Prize. This country is eager to see an increase in the number. I am sure it will come from amongst you. Friends, to improve the standards of higher education, we must improve the quality of teachers, the learning capacity of students, and the physical infrastructure. But physical infrastructure alone will count for nothing unless it is matched by the quality of human capital that comprises the academic community. The faculty, to be of high order, must keep themselves abreast with the latest developments. The National College, National Knowledge Network offers an effective solution to the academic institutions to connect, collaborate, and disseminate ideas, views, findings, and research innovations. Using the network can compensate many of the shortages in terms of faculty, infrastructure, and resources that hinder an institution from offering a great learning experience. We also have to project our universities In a more proactive manner, our institutions have to accord due seriousness to the university ranking process. A higher rank can boost the morale of the academic and the students' communities. It will also help in opening fresh avenues of growth and placement for students. Better rankings will also encourage a greater flow of faculty and students from abroad, opening new vistas of frontier technology. I am confident of some Indian universities and institutes making it to the list of world's top 200 universities in near future. Friends, during some of my visit to central universities, IITs and NITs, I have had the opportunity to interact with the inspired teachers. They are such teachers who make their students appreciate a subject from a wider perspective and encourage them to explore beyond the frontiers of their discipline. By their own examples, they instill good moral values in their students. These teachers must be encouraged to share their wisdom, thoughts, and experiences with the larger academic community. An inspired teachers lecture series can be initiated to carry forward the benefits of excellence in teaching. My dear students, pursuit of academic excellence should be accompanied by the quest for moral development. Your preparedness in life should be on the foundation of essential values of patriotism, compassion, tolerance, integrity, and equality. You, the young ones, are the bright future of our nation. The extent of our progress will be decided by your energy, drive, initiative, and industry. Understand our nation and its institutions. Read, learn, and formulate views on national issues. Choose to engage with our beautiful, complex, often difficult, and sometimes noisy democracy. Understand your right and duties well, especially towards those who are less fortunate. The voiceless deserve your voice. The weak deserve your strength, and the needy deserve your help. Make the best use of your knowledge in the service of the nation and its citizens. Remember what the great teacher, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, had said, and I quote, "All education is on the one side a search for truth. On the other side, it is a pursuit of social betterment. You may discover truth, but you should apply it to improve the status of society." Unquote. In conclusion, I would like to once again wish all of you a very happy and rewarding year ahead. It is time for new beginnings. The air is thick with hope and expectation. Let this be a year of new opportunities and achievements. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.
On behalf of all the students and faculty of central universities, NITs, IITs, and other central institutions, I have the honor and privilege to thank Sri Pranab Mukherjee, the Honorable President of India, for the New Year message. by choosing to address the country's premier institutions of higher education at the beginning of the new year, the Honorable President has conveyed a very clear message that we should make a new year resolution to set a definite roadmap for achieving higher standards of academic excellence so that our institutions are counted among the best in the world. Ever since he occupied the August office, the Honorable President has traveled the length and breadth of the country and addressed various educational institutions where his concern has been that not a single university or institution finds a place in the top 200 in the world. By highlighting the poor ranking of Indian institutions, the Honorable President is ringing the alarm bells. How can a country that is striving to free itself from the shackles of poverty afford to ignore education in our development efforts? Being the visitor to nearly 100 institutions of higher education, his anguish is both understandable and justified. Honorable President has made it abundantly clear that the quality of education in institutions of higher learning is his top priority. This culminated into a conference of vice chancellors of central universities, which was held in the Rashtrapati Bhavan in February 2013. Recently, in November 7-8, 2013, the directors of 30 NITs were invited to first ever conference in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Through all these initiatives, the Honorable President is exhorting the institutions of higher education to take up the challenge of enhancing the quality of education and effectively contribute to the nation building. The Honorable President's prescription for the quality of these institutions is specific: benchmark with the best institutions in the world, adopt their standards and best practices. By using video conferencing facility through National Knowledge Network for this address, the Honorable President has stressed the need